life right now is loblolly pine. Loblolly pine is a really common pine across the Southeast. It's especially known for its ability to do really well in plantation settings. They're planted a lot by industrial forest landowners because they grow really quickly early on, get up above the competition, and then because they have really good height and diameter growth, they're able to use them for higher end forest products like lumber and 2x4s, plywood, things like that. Loblolly pine is often found planted in lots of situations. You may find it planted in old fields. You may find it planted in kind of upland sites and also in bottomland sites. Loblolly pine was actually found naturally in bottoms and drains. If you think about the common name of loblolly, you gotta think about what does loblolly mean? And I ask my students this a lot, like, what does the word loblolly mean? And a lot of them don't know that it's actually an old timey word for a mud hole. I would always tell my students too, or always say that my grandma used to tell me, you know, Becky, when I was little, said, Becky, don't go out there and get your clean clothes dirty and wallow around in that loblolly. And essentially what she was telling me was stay out of the mud hole and stay clean. So that's something to remember. Loblolly really does a lot better in bottomland sites rather than in upland sites. A lot of times people plant loblolly in uplands and then they start to have lots of cones in the crown as they get a little older. Maybe they start to see one or two here or there dying back. And this is really kind of loblolly's last effort to reproduce, to get seed on the ground before it dies. So that's really something that's kind of a warning sign. If you have loblolly pine and you're starting to see it with lots and lots of cones in the crown, you may want to have your forester come out and take a look at it and see if there's something maybe that needs to be done, because you may have a lot of mortality in the near future. Loblolly actually really is kind of a nutrient hog in some cases, where it needs a lot of water. It needs a lot of nutrients. So poor sites, rocky sites, loblolly just doesn't do as well. Loblolly is also has a really light seed, and so it can blow for long distances. And so historically, when historical forests were cut, when like the longleaf forests were cut historically, loblolly was one of those first early pioneer species because the seed would blow for a long way. Loblolly doesn't do very well with fire. It was found in these moisture areas, so historically as fire moved across the landscape, it would kind of fizzle out literally and figuratively as it got into those bottoms. And so what would happen is that loblolly kind of evolved to be not as fire tolerant as some of the other pine species. So again, loblolly doesn't do as well with fire. When they get older, you can use fire in the understory, but on younger loblolly like these behind me, a lot of times they don't do as well. They can be killed by even low intensity fires, in part because they have limbs that go all the way pretty much to the ground when they're younger, and that kind of acts as a fire ladder and can just bring that fire right on up into the crown and eventually kill the trees. A lot of times people have a hard time identifying the different southern pines, and it can be sort of confusing. But there's some things to remember when you're looking at loblolly. One is the cone. The cone is kind of smaller, but one of the most notable things about the cone is that when you touch it, it has these little spikes on the edges, so it makes it very prickly when you pick it up. Sometimes some people find it very uncomfortable to pick up because it does have these sharp burrs on the ends of the cone. So that's one thing to identify. Again, it's not a very large cone, 5 to 6 inches long. Another way to identify them is through the needles. You can see here the needles on this younger loblolly pine. They do kind of run down the new growth, run down the stem, and they're usually in bundles in the fascicle of three. So usually you can tell a loblolly because they're usually in bundles of three. One other thing to think about when you're looking at loblolly and helping to identify it, it's of note to think about the bark. The bark on loblolly is not as thick as that on some of the other southern pines. You see when it's younger, it can be a little bit flaky, but again, the bark layer on loblolly is very thin. And again, that comes from the fact that it has evolved without fire for the most part and is not a very fire tolerant species, especially when it's younger.